guys, welcome back to my channel, and today my mum will be doing a face paint on me. We are going to be doing the colourful creepy clown from Jordan Hans, and so I hope you enjoy.
Okay.
Has so it got water on there? So mum's trying to use water activated paints without water. And she's going to be using the Paradise white paint.
Okay, we're going to try and make the shape of a mouth by the look of it. So we'll have a go. Must be very tickly.
Shot through mouth and now. A little twisty, the clown inspired.
And I'm now already grabbing run out of paint. Apparently I'm not allowed to stand in front of the camera, so you're not going to see anything. But we shall try. Now she's got this squiggly thing at the bottom. Do I have to do that too?
No.
No?
Okay. So FYI, Mum's never painted a face in her life.
Ever. Have you? Never. Never.
Never.
This is a first, and I'm enjoying it already. Because...
Are you?
I'm not going to put any pressure on myself because I'm new to all of this. Now, I assume I get a fluffy brush and I start with the yellow.
You can use that one.
Or, you know, I need some direction here. I've got no idea.
You have to ask Jordan.
Jordan, do I use?
She's doing it. She's showing you.
Okay. Where do I start? We'll start here, where she started. And I apologise if I get it anywhere that it shouldn't be.
Can you show the people at home how you're holding your sponge? Okay. Right up close. So it focuses on it. She's bent it over. I've never used a sponge like that before.
There's a for everything. But see, that's one of the things I've seen them do. Is bend the sponge.
Is it? Who did that?
Ooh, I'm pretty sure I've seen it somewhere. Or maybe that was in the cleaning room.
Oh geez.
What? Is that too much?
Go easy on the water.
Too much water.
I can feel it. Oh. Nice and drippy. It looks exactly like what she's doing.
But you know what? We might come up with a totally different style. We might come up with the drippy scary clown. And do you know what? It just might look fantastic.
I feel like I look like
a... But you know.
I feel like I look like a minion.
Now, do I go over your eyebrows as well?
Yeah.
Bridie will have to tell you what it is because
so it focuses. Like, right. Like, so you can see it in the actual screen.
Where?
No, you don't have to follow the square.
Right. Now,
so Mum's using wedge makeup sponge. Yep, that's the one. They've seen it now.
Yeah, okay. So,
what she's doing is she's pulling out little bits.
Is she pulling them out?
Go like this. It just helps you do a dappled, mottled effect on the skin.
Apparently, I'm going to dapple now. By pulling out little bits like that. Do I put it on your nose as well?
Yeah, just dab on my neck.
Was that a signal for something? Because if it was, I really
was dabbing.
You were what?
Dabbing. Have you seen the kids go like that?
No.
Full of dad.
Bags underneath your eyes. Is that right? A baggy sort of look.
Yeah. What?
Oh, actually, she did it from the edge of the eye, but I've sort of made it a bit bigger. Is that okay?
Yeah. If I'm on the camera again.
Right. It's very hard to do that side without being in front. Well, turn your head to me then. Jordan's doing little circles around your nostrils now.
Also defining the rest of the face, making my nose look a little bigger and deeper. And since we have this huge smile, obviously we'd have to have some big...
If you could turn to me so I can do my
nostril circles.
But it's interesting the way she uses those parts of her features.
Every human's features.
Yeah.
Nostril circles.
And what else is she doing? She seems to be doing something over down to the
She's
mouth
doing
as well.
The smile lines.
A smile. Do you want her smile?
Yeah, well, look at the big smile I created. Need a smile line.
And doing something over there. So she seems to be making splotchy bits on the side.
Splotchy bits, eh?
Well, I could say they actually...
She's making the temples sunken in looking.
Okay.
Any sideburns?
Well, no, she did it in two spots.
Mm-hmm. She's doing a head grab.
Sorry, you want to turn your head around then? Yes. You know, like a skull thing is very similar to...
Well, it's a clown actually. A skull. A yellow jaundiced skull.
I'm in front of the camera because you've got to turn towards me, otherwise
So what do you think of this painting experience?
I think it would take many, many years of practice to get this right because
like 10 years? Show them what you're doing.
I've outlined the big mouth.
I look like I haven't slept in 10 years.
Mm.
You finished yet?
No. So I have to fill it in.
It's taking too long.
You sound like a kid.
Really?
My kid.
Oh. What are you using? This is what the kids do to me. I'm a face painter. She paints really well.
Who are you talking about?
I've been a kid.
You've been
still a clown, aren't I? Are you still making me a clown?
Yeah, I think I am.
Show them what you've done. It looks like the Joker. So you're on kind of on the right track there.
And then she's got a different shaped one over there. Why is that? It's like a bigger one.
Yeah. It's the molars. You know, like...
Like the one I had taken out the other day, and I've got a big gap in my mouth.
Those bloody molars.
Mm. Yeah.
Know.
It doesn't, it should be colour underneath here, but I don't see
colour underneath.
Have it. Because I don't know. Anyway, it might turn out in the end. Now she's.
Trust the process. So, Mum's going to be using a Chi Chi eyeshadow palette, so she'll be using this colour.
Where else do you...
My mouth's getting bigger and bigger. If you make a mistake, keep making things bigger.
So she's going around the edge and she's making little ditchy things.
Yeah, that was the technical wording she used. Jesus. You want to... Mum goes a little bit heavy-handed. I look like I've got like a monobrow rather than frown lines.
Mm.
What do you think? Does it look like hers?
Well, it's not going to be as good as hers. Uh-huh. But I reckon I'm getting it. Can you just sort of go like that? Yeah, because I reckon that's the way they do it. They get you to make faces and then they can put in...
Like a worried sort of, what are you doing to my face?
Yeah. That's right. And they can really... You know?
So Mum's shading the teeth so they've got dimension.
This is such a long process.
Mm. 10 years later.
Outside the door, very patiently waiting for some attention, haven't you?
It's
Smiley Moo.
Hey. What do you think? What do you think, Bridie?
Face.
Smiley.
What do you think? Ooh. Her eyes are a bit bulgy right now. Does that mean you're scaring her?
So I'm gonna just give him a little kiss, okay. You guys already know the final step, highlighting the best step brings everything together. I wanna highlight the high points of the look. That includes the gums, the very center of those gum lines because they would protrude outwards. And that highlight with a little bit of that cream paint just helps to kind of make it look like it is more three-dimensional.
Does it look spitty?
Yeah, I think it does. maybe it should be a bit thinner. But
what, you painting it or Jordan painting it?
No, me.
Why don't you do it thinner then? Just don't press as hard on the brush.
Oh, okay.
Up close. Yeah. I mean, it looks scary. Kind of like... kind of like the entertainment, the clown's like, I've got this today. I don't need to hire a professional.
So the tears? Dribbly.
Dribbly, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Well, tears don't go straight down, you know.
They go, how do they go? We got this one. It's from eBay. It's an eBay wig.
See you through the window now, so you know
you probably already scared them.
So tell us about your face painting experience.
It was really good. I enjoyed it. I don't know that I got it entirely right, but I liked it.
What do you guys think? Does Mum have potential?
Thumbs up.
Yeah. So give us a thumbs up if you think it's a good look for me, for my next kids' party. and also please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.
Bye.
Bye.
Maybe I should have worn my glasses.
Probably. That might have been a good idea.